been said tonight. Thank you all so much. It's been an extraordinary evening. So many friends, such a lifetime of relationships and projects and things to do, and I just love that you all are here tonight. Really appreciate it. So, Dr. J. Robinson was a great leader for education in North Carolina. As we know, he was a teacher, principal, superintendent, chair of the state board, and a leader at the University of North Carolina system. He was a champion for education, so I am indeed honored to receive this wonderful award in his name. His legacy continues through the public school forum's research, analysis, and advocacy. For more than 30 years, the forum has shaped education policy in our state by raising public awareness, providing research-based information, and stimulating discussion. We are grateful and applaud the dedication and diligence of Keith Poston, the forum staff, and Mike Pretty and the forum board for their important contributions for public education in North Carolina. So I grew up in a time when the issue was equality in our education system, to understand that separate was not equal. Today we recognize that being equal is not enough. Equality is fairness. Equity is giving everyone what they need to succeed. When we think about educational equity for North Carolina public school students, we must strive to ensure that every child has the opportunity and the supports to realize his or her full potential. So as we know, in 1997, the North Carolina Supreme Court ruled unanimously that the state's children have a constitutional right to the opportunity to receive a sound basic education. Although some progress has been made, budget cuts and competing interests have caused North Carolina to struggle to live up to the requirements of that ruling. That constitutional ruling obligates the state to ensure every student has full access to a quality education that prepares them for the jobs and opportunities of the future. It is our responsibility to see that our students are performing at grade level and leave high school fully prepared for college and careers in this global economy. Furthermore, we must recognize that a sound basic education today requires a mastery of much more difficult standards and skills than was required 20 years ago. Changes in the economy have ratcheted up the skills and education attainments needed to earn a decent living. Meeting these challenges requires a sustained focus on educational equity. The quality of an education is not only key to the individual's success, but it's also key to the social and economic success of our state. Our state's growth depends on the quality of our citizens, and the quality of our citizens depends on the quality of our education system. A significant roadblock to achieving educational equity is our current patchwork of education policies and programs. The lack of an aligned, comprehensive education continuum leads to the dysfunctional development of the talent our state needs. And that talent is our greatest asset for the future. Talent comes from all sections of society, all races, all genders, and all income levels. It is unacceptable to allow a child's success to be determined by race, socioeconomic status, or zip code. We must infuse equity into a comprehensive education continuum that ensures all students, rural and urban, can achieve their full academic potential. Every student, including low-income students, students of color, English language learners, and students with disabilities, should have the confidence to know that they can become what they want to be in their career future. All children must have the opportunities they need to have a fair shot of upward mobility. To achieve this vision, we need to confront the reality that North Carolina has significant achievement gaps, particularly among children of poverty and children of color. While our high school graduation rate has risen somewhat, that rate belies the fact that only 49% of those graduates are truly career and college ready. For those who are economically disadvantaged, that percentage drops to 34%. And for those with limited English proficiency, that percentage drops to 15%. The recently released NAEP reading and math scores are generally flat across the country. This is a disappointing reminder that we are making little progress in transforming education. The achievement gaps that exist along racial and socioeconomic lines have for far too long dominated our education profile. This disparity starts in elementary school and only widens in middle and high school. The NAEP scores should be a catalyst for change. They should cause us to examine existing policies to better understand what is effective and what isn't working. They should propel us to take steps to positively disrupt our education system with one goal in mind: to do better for all students. While we must recognize there is no single solution to achieve equity, attaining equity requires improvements throughout the entire education continuum. It starts at the beginning with our youngest children, where achievement gaps that fuel future skills gaps begins. Low-income children lag well behind children from higher-income families by the time they enter kindergarten. The best way to reduce those gaps is to increase access to high-quality early learning programs. Young children less likely to become successful students are those who enter kindergarten with a solid set of school readiness skills, knowledge of letters, numbers, shapes, and phonic sounds. Successful early learners have also begun developing foundational cognitive skills or executive functioning. Key to laying all of these foundations for student success are our high-quality NC Pre-K and other early learning programs. Our NC Pre-K program is one of the top-ranked in the country, but unfortunately, all children who are eligible do not have access to it, primarily because of lack of funding. This has to change. But the work does not stop there. We know that third grade reading proficiency is one of the single best indicators for student success. Ninth graders who were reading proficiently at the end of third grade are three times more likely to pursue post-secondary work. Conversely, children who were not reading proficiently at the end of third grade are four times more likely to drop out of school. Again, the recent NAEP scores show we have much work to do, as only 39% of North Carolina's fourth graders are reading proficiently. We must continue our focus on this key education milestone and implement approaches to identify and work with struggling readers as soon as possible to keep them on the road to success. To achieve equity in our schools, the recruitment and retention of effective teachers and school leaders is crucial. Research shows that effective teachers are the most important factor contributing to student achievement. In reality, however, teacher quality is inequitably distributed. The students with the greatest needs tend to have the less effective teachers. Furthermore, more underperforming schools experience greater teacher turnover, which can be harmful to disadvantaged students. There are programs and strategies underway that should help level this playing field, but it really, there is no silver bullet, and it's really going to take all of us to make sure it happens. There are some working to build stronger partnerships between districts and educator preparation programs. These partnerships promote better understanding of what is actually happening in classrooms while incorporating best practices supported by research to increase educator effectiveness. On another front, we should design career paths and compensation structures to reward and support our most effective teachers and school leaders. Incentives to stay in struggling schools are crucial to promote continuity and stability, especially given that the neediest schools are the most difficult to staff. We must recruit and retain outstanding teachers who also reflect the racial makeup of the community, because research confirms that having teachers of color has a positive impact on students of color. Finally, in this day and time, the need for more professional counselors, nurses, and other support staff to assist in the school workday is more apparent than ever, especially in the lives of our students and teachers. These professionals are either not available or have such large caseloads they cannot be effective. In sum, education is the best path out of poverty. Recognizing the barriers created by poverty and race, and making a commitment to take action to provide that sound basic education for all our children is our collective responsibility and their constitutional right. To have high expectations for every child and a deep understanding of equity and inclusion is the ultimate test of who we are and what we value as a society. Thank you very much.